Hey everybody, my name's Lee McCormack. I'm with RipRo and Ride Logic. Excuse me, and Lee Likes Bikes. Right now I'm in the RipRo warehouse, which is glamorous. Alright, so let's talk. I'm gonna try to make this fast. I tend to like ramble. Hinging, okay? We have basically three major positions for our hips when we ride. And of course, we exist on a continuum between them. We can be straight up upright like this. We'll go here. When we need to express like full torque, like a heavy deadlift, big bunny hop, climbing a steep ledge, okay? We also have hinging. And hinging is the key to shredding, by the way. In a hinge, I'll do it with this bar in my hand. In a hinge, you basically take your pelvis and you rotate it on top of your femur. And your, for our purposes, your pelvis and your whole torso are one thing. Tons of core strength. This is just a lever. And this lever basically opposes this lever right here. So check it out. In a hinge, with our feet straight, always start here because you're going to be tight. We're going to push our hips back, rotate our torso level. Boom. So I think my torso is level, right? So what I've gone to here is a pretty low hinge. We have a low hinge. We have a high hinge. In the low hinge, you drop your hips and your knees will come right around to the middle of your feet or right above, say, the foot pegs, okay? In a high hinge, your torso should stay level, your core should stay on, okay? And in a high hinge, your legs will go basically straight. They're not gonna walk straight, but your knees will be right above your heels. So you have low hinge, high hinge, and that movement right there is the key to downhilling. It allows us to absorb impacts through our hips. It allows us some pumping power, and it keeps our torsos low so we can corner, we can go off drops, we can pump, we can do all the stuff we like to do, okay? So. And by the way, the bigger the delta, the bigger the difference between your high hinge and your low hinge, the more power you can get from your hips. And this is cool for riding. The more power you can get from your hips, the less relative work has to be done by your upper body. So when you're ripping downhill, like most of the big work is going to go to the middle of your body where it belongs, and your arms will kind of help manage angles. That's a better role for them than supporting your weight, okay? So check it out. Well, again, we have a high hinge, which you might be thinking, that looks a lot like a Romanian deadlift. It does. We have a low hinge, and you might be saying to yourself, that looks like a standard deadlift, which it does, okay? We also have available to us, okay, for a moment where we really have to absorb something super big, okay? And when you're in a low hinge, like, your hips will run out of movement range, and your chest or your belly will hit your thigh. That's where I am right now. So in a really low, super low hinge, we can spread our knees out and get even deeper. I mean, I'm at the very, very end of the range of this RipRo, and that means that I can ride down something very, very steep. By the way, that's a big confidence thing, right? If I just know, like, I can close my eyes and just stay balanced, and pass through this crazy range of motion, boom, then I know I can ride whatever trails come my way. Okay, so that's with your feet next to each other. That's hard enough. That takes a fair amount of core engagement and a lot of hamstring. But check it out. And if you were a motocross racer, that's all you have to worry about. But if you're a BMXer or a mountain biker or a cyclocross racer, etc., even a roadie, you know, you have to live on pedals. So these are the optional pedal platforms, and I'm putting them in my switch stance. Forever I've been riding left foot forward, but when I'm on the machine, I always practice right foot forward. So now, I'm okay either way. Not great, but okay. So check it out. So now our feet have to be in this crazy stance. I'm putting the balls of my feet right on these pedals. It feels exactly like riding like a nice quality pair of flat pedals. Okay? So we have upright, that's always easy. You ready for this? We have a high hinge, And in the high hinge, the legs are pretty straight. And the torso should be pretty darn level, okay? This, can you see this angle right here? This takes an insane amount of hamstring flexibility. And the longer you cranks are, the harder this is. So it's a good reason to go short cranks. We have a high hinge, we have a low hinge. And I'm instinctively, just because my belly and my chest are in the way, I can only go so low. So when I go to this low hinge, I'm gonna bring my knees out of here. And I could potentially, again, like if I can get all the way to the end of the range with this machine, like I know that I can ride down some crazy steep stuff. So we have a low hinge and a high hinge. And of course we're human, right? So things will start to break down. I am, you know, a little tight and I'm tired because I did like hard hill intervals this morning and some pretty serious strength work on this, of course. We want to be able to keep our torsos completely level, keep our hips exactly in the right space, right? Between our high and our low. Most of us will tend to kind of curl or do various things. That's normal, but we really want to do our best not to. So I've really braced my core. I'm getting as low as I can get. I'm getting as high as I can get. But I'm really trying to keep my torso level. This will allow me to function on a downhill. Like, ideally, this is hard, right? Ideally, you can get this range with your feet level on the deck of the riprap. This takes a lot of dorsiflexion, flexibility, and just general mobility. It's completely okay, though, okay? Ooh, damn, I can't believe how hard that is. It's completely okay, and you see this a lot. As you come into that lower hinge, it's completely cool to raise that right heel. You see this a lot, and there's nothing wrong, that's okay. And if you're on the pedals, or on your real bike, you can make it even easier, okay, by, I'm really sweating, this is a lot of work. By dropping your front heel and raising your rear heel. And again, you see riders do this all the time. And by the way, you notice how my knees are right next to each other? That's perfect. I call that the triangle of awesome. That becomes our base. So we could go to a very, very low hinge with our knees out a bit, kind of a normal low hinge, and a high hinge. And I'm looking at the deck, I should be looking forward. And I should be keeping my upper back straight as well. But we're human. I did a lot of PT today. Already. So, you got that? High hinge, low hinge, crazy low hinge, high hinge. And whew, the better you are at functioning between that low and high hinge, with balance, with core integration, and staying out of a squat pattern, the better you are at that, the better you can ride. I mean, there's no question about it. So have fun out there, and bye, Ripra. Take care.